When a person makes a discovery or creates something new, who does the idea belong to? Most people would say the person that created it, right? Who has the authority to say who can use it? Again, most people would say the person that developed, discovered, or created it. But is that always the case? And if I wanted to use a tool or idea that someone else created, is that allowed? Copyright is the legal term to describe ownership of an idea, discovery, or creation of something. Patents are closely related to copyright. They are the legal description of the idea, discovery, or creation. For this class, we are going to focus our discussion on the use of copyrighted material. To begin, a discoverer, creator, or designer of an original work or idea can claim ownership of that original thing when it is in a tangible form. That means it has been written or recorded or made and is no longer just an idea, but has physical properties. It is a good idea for authors and creators to record the date of the creation, especially since others may come up with the same idea. The United States Copyright Office of the Library of Congress has the official responsibility to maintain registration of copyrighted materials, but copyright is automatically granted to the owner once it is in tangible form. Permission must be granted by the owner for someone else to use that idea. However, copyright expires 70 years after the author or creator's death, although it can be renewed. When copyright expires on a particular idea or creation, then it is part of the public domain and can be used without awaiting permission, but giving credit to the originator. There are some circumstances that copyrighted materials can be used on the assumption that permission would be granted, which is called fair use. This is addressed in Section 8 of the Copyright Act in the United States Code, which was last revised in 1976. Fair use applies to using material for the purpose of reporting the news and current events, so video clips from sports events can be played in news programs. Fair use also applies when quoting sections of written and performed works for commentary and critiques, such as reviews. Again, it is fair use that allows parodies, such as skits that are puns or interpretations of creative works. However, the most common application is using copyrighted material for educational or scholarly purposes, such as research. Although each of these purposes of using copyrighted material can assume the author or creator gives permission, they still have ownership and must be cited as the creator. Even though fair use assumes permission, there are some limits and conditions to using the material. The first factor is the nature of the copyrighted work. Is the original a painting, poem, musical recording, electrical circuit? Is it something easily shared? The next factor is the amount of the original that is used. No more than 10% of the original is allowed. This is why only short video clips can be used, especially for commentary and news programs of sports events and film reviews. The most important factor to determine if fair use applies is the impact on the market. This often is the major reason for permission to be required, especially if used in advertising or other commercial use. The last condition to be met is that the purpose and character of use must not devalue the original. For all of these factors, the amount of the original is a key element, and less is always better. In the late 20th century, the internet and electronic formats drastically changed many aspects of sharing original works. Files were frequently shared via social media and email, posted on websites, and the Copyright Office addressed the issue again. They determined that the same rules about fair use apply to electronic formats, so the copyright code was not revised. However, the Technology, Education, and Copyright Harmonization Act was passed in 2002 to address the use of electronic formats in education. The TEACH Act specifies requirements that apply only to a government body or to an accredited nonprofit educational institution, and the educational institution must develop and institute policies regarding use of copyrighted materials, and the institution must provide informational materials regarding copyright. Each instructor must notify students that any materials provided for the course are subject to copyright protection, and that the content must be made available only to the students enrolled in the course, and access expires after the course is over. Instructors need to make sure students understand that the materials may not be distributed to people outside the class, and any copies need to be destroyed.